Okay, that should be good. I'm still not very good at ending things or saying goodbye. Because, a lot of YouTubers have very specific intros and extras. Extras? Outros. It's like almost subconsciously programmed in my brain. I don't want to do Markiplier's outro, which is see you in the next video. Bye bye. But it's so easy to say though. It covers what you need to say, but I don't want to be directly copying him, of course. Ooh, light bridge. Filtered sunlight. Hard light bridge.
From natural light that I pump in from the surface. If you rubbed your cheek on one, it would be like standing outside with the sun shining on your face. It would also set your hair on fire, so don't actually do it.
You can't tell me what to do. Yeah, hard light bridges. And the nice thing about this is, these are infinite. They just kind of keep going. Also, they make a fun sound when you walk across them. It's almost like you're figure skating. Let's see. So this now needs to go. Oh, it's dropping over there. So what I need to do is that so I can catch. That didn't catch it. Luckily, it's gonna keep falling over and over again. Oops, that was the wrong one. I wanted orange. Let's see. I need to go over there. So I need to line this up just so I don't fall in. There. And now we can catch the cube. Okay, and the button is over there. How do we get over there? It's be a lot faster to just do this. Let's see. Okay, except I can't get over there now, so let's go back over here and then there we go. And well, bam. Button pressed. The only issue now is we need to get back over there, which we can do. Doing this.
Excellent.
Ta-da!
You're a predator, and these tests are your prey.
Heck yeah, they are.
Speaking of which, I was researching sharks for an upcoming test. Do you know who else murders people who are only trying to help them? Did you guess
Bees.
sharks? Because that's wrong. The
No,
correct
bees don't do
answer is
that.
nobody. Nobody but you is that pointlessly cruel.
I mean, she does have a point. I did kill her, but she tried to kill me first,
Anyways,
so.
I figured out what to do with all the money I saved recycling your one room full of air. When you die, I'm going to laminate your skeleton and pose you in the lobby. That way, future
Oh, that
generations will
reminds
see
me.
a
I should be
veteran of
sitting up
Common Law
straight.
that had your unfortunate bones
My mom was
fractured.
yelling at me yesterday for slouching all the time. Okay, number 12 looks like it's hard light bridges and cubes.
The door's malfunctioning. I guess somebody's going to have to repair that too. No, don't get up. I'll be right back. Don't touch anything.
She sounds like my mother. Yeah, there he is.
I found some bird eggs up here. Just dropped me to the door mechanism. Shut it right down. Bird!
So yeah, someone at Valve has some bird issues.
Livid. Okay, look, the point is, we're going to break out of here, all right? Very soon, I promise. I just have to figure out how to break us out of here. Here she comes. Keep testing. Remember, you never saw me.
Nope. Didn't see anything.
I went and spoke with the door mainframe. Let's just say he won't be, well, living anymore. Anyway, back to testing.
Alright, Retman Den in the ceiling. Is it up there or is it up here? I think it's up here. Because it looks like there's some space for you to walk. Yeah, I was just thinking that, the bird we just saw, as Britt pointed out, Britt, the portal expert, that wasn't actually a bird. Like, their birds are very, very low poly. I'm confused, how do I get over there? So they made the glass wavy so you couldn't see just how low poly the birds are. There we go. Oh, yeah, I do see it up there. Question is, how do I get up there? Let's see. Oh, there it is. I just had to move a bit. A little behind the scenes here. Gosh, what is that a painting of? So there's another moon reference. There's a lot of moon references. There is no magic, only lost physics. Missing. I like that little. You can kind of see how he was living. Like, he's like all, it's got all these like generic cans of beans. Yes, zoom in on the beans. God knows what else. Although, if it's food made by Aperture, I probably wouldn't be eating it, but it's not like he has much of a choice. I think this is GLaDOS. It's a little hard to tell. There's a shadow, like, right there. I mean, it kind of... That kind of looks like the, base she had, and then all the wires connecting, but then there's no... mechanism or robot face connected to it, I suppose. Although that might be GLaDOS's face, her new one. It's kind of hard to tell with this lighting. Also, something I just noticed. He's been painting primarily in white, black, and now orange and blue. There's red in the last one, which I'm assuming is probably blood. But, like, these specific gels that we're going to be testing with later that are orange or blue, and I'm wondering if that's what he's painting with. Because, and then he can get white to get different shades and such, and then I don't know what he'd be, using for the black. I don't know. Probably whatever he can find. Yeah, and they are the usual Aperture colors. Like I said before in a previous video, orange and blue are exact opposites, so it's good to use as a game mechanic, because then it's very easy to tell stuff apart. But, like, I just kind of, like, that it's a little interesting, because you do find paint cans in some of the rat dens, but maybe they're not paint cans, maybe they're gel cans. I just kind of like that there's that little explanation behind it. Even if it is, like, just keeping with the color scheme, there is a real-world explanation on how he would be using those colors and why he might be using those colors. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. I wasn't gonna hit that.
Back to testing.
Exactly. Back to testing. Don't want to spend too much time on the rat dens. Okay, so that's actually over a bit. Oh yeah, see it, look right there. They put that this one panel is different from the rest because it's gridded. I always want to put, like, not so much hints in gameplay and design, but you do want to draw the viewer's eye, and that is a good way to be doing that. Let's see. I wonder if there's, like, if I can get at a better angle to... No, it doesn't look like I can do that. Let's see if I can get that just a... No, not that much lower. Just a hair. No, that's not close enough. Oh, I see what I need to do. I do this. No! It fell off. Aw, man. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, how about, no, I do have to beat. I fell. These light bridges are very narrow. Okay, good. It looks like it saved me right here. I don't think it saves depending on how much time you spend. I think it saves more on how many portals you've placed. I don't know. I don't know how this save system works. The auto save, rather. Okay. Let's be a bit more careful about things. Good. Didn't fall off this time. Neither one of us did.
Section.
Oh boy!
Oh, there's lots of room here. Did well. Enough.
Oh, enough. But yay, I have something in the accommodation sections now. Commendations? Commendations. Commendations.
This next test involves turrets. You
realize. Yay, turrets!
The pale spherical things that are full of bullets. Oh wait, that's you in 5 seconds.
60% bullet per bullet. Or 60% more bullet per bullet. Yeah, so interesting fact about the turrets is The reason why they don't kill you instantly is because they're not actually being, their guns don't fire using gunpowder. They're pushed out with a mechanism, or it's a pneumatic-based propulsion rather than a internal combustion propulsion. So there's not as much oomph behind them, so the bullets don't, like, they do penetrate your skin, but not really, which explains why you can get hit with these, and, like, you don't bleed in this game. You bleed in the first game, but not in the second one. They're spring-loaded. Thank you, Garen. Or Britt. Same name. Which explains why you don't bleed in this one, and also why you don't die right away when you get hit. And these turrets are so much cuter in this game. Mostly... Oops! Jeez, I barely bumped into it. Like, they're so cute and sweet. There you go, little buddy. Surprise! And again, the music picks up when you pick up the turrets. It's cute. I'm gonna see how many I can get away with not deactivating. I'm so glad they added music. The music is fantastic in this game. Right, now this is where things get a bit more tricky. Cube, shield me! No one's there. I don't know what you're talking about. It's just annoying that they go a little overboard when they fall over. You also note that the turrets are a bit smarter now and they don't start shooting you. Because in the old games, like even if there was glass in the way, they'd start firing at this point. But not anymore. But yeah, when they got knocked over, they start shooting all crazy, and you can still get hit and get hurt from that. Whee! Dramatic music every time someone gets hit. What you say? It's not quite lined up. Nope, nobody's deploying anything. And they put in just enough cubes for the turrets. It didn't quite work. I am over here. I'm right behind you. Just gonna put you here in the corner where you can't hurt anybody. Fun fact, the turrets are voiced by Ellen McClain as well. It's just the GLaDOS voice pitched up and not sassy. There. All the cubes. Oh my. Nope. Okay. This is fine. Oh, guys, we escaped. We didn't even need Wheatley. We're just out now already. Sorry. I spent all day in bed to stay warm.
To
It's made
maintain
me
a
really
constant
sleepy.
testing cycle, I simulate daylight at all hours and add adrenal vapor to your oxygen supply. So you may be confused about the passage of time. The point is, yesterday was your birthday. I thought you'd want to know.
So this is how they put all the floors in. Interesting. Oh, it looks like there's some incineration going on over there though. Don't wanna. Yep. Okay, so maybe we're not out, but we got close. Yeah, I remember this one. I remember this one very vividly. Let's see. Yeah, we put that there, and then this here. Oh, and I don't know if you can hear, but for every single one that's activated, it adds another layer onto the music that's playing. So once I activate this.
You know how I'm going to live forever, but you're going to be dead in 60 years? Well, I've been working on a belated birthday present for you. Well, more of a belated birthday medical procedure. Well, technically, it's a medical experiment. What's important is it's a present.
See, it's important that it's what the thought that counts. See, GLaDOS is so nice and thoughtful. Sorry. I'm
I
awake. I'm
apologize that
awake.
you're wearing looks stupid.
Oh.
That's not me talking. It's right here in your file. On other people, it looks fine. But right here, a scientist has noted that on you, it looks stupid. Well, what does a neck-bearded old engineer know about fashion? He probably. Oh, wait. It's a she. Still, what does she know? Oh,
Oh
wait.
wait,
It's
it says she
Sophia
has a medical
Moore.
degree in fashion from France. Yay, look at all these turrets. Whoops! Got a little too close there. Wait, how do I get past it? I don't even remember. Oh, I remember. Haha. Try and get me now. Let's just place that a little shorter just to make me feel better. Let's see. You know, I haven't gotten a chance to show off Chell's model yet. You can see her pretty okay through there, but I wanna definitely get to a point where it's a little more clear. 'Cause her model is so much better in this game. And I love how she wears the jumpsuit, 'cause she's like got it fashionably tied around her waist. Right, okay. Let's see. Do I remember how to do this? That went well. I didn't actually need to go here. Oh gosh. Have I trapped myself in here now? I think I did. Oh. Can sort of get a better look at her now from the back. Oh my gosh, my entire leg is asleep. Oh, ow, ow. It's weird, why isn't that working? Yeah, now you can get a little bit better look. Whoops, that was the wrong portal. I meant to shoot the blue one, or the orange one, or whichever one. Okay, let's try that again. Nope, no deploying for you. Let's see, I believe what I want to do is this. There we go. Okay, so now I want to put that there. Yeah, I do remember them. Oh yeah, this is actually a test where you can get yourself stuck. And GLaDOS will have to reset for you. Oh gosh, I can't remember how to do this! I need to get in there. I don't remember. I think I have to. Let's see, that's orange. That should keep me safe. Nope, okay. I'm dead. Sorry, like I said, it's been a while, and this was definitely one I've gotten stuck on before in the past. No one's there, don't be silly. So, now I can get up real close. Oh! Is one of you still standing? Let's see if I can fix that. There we go. Okay, so orange goes there first, and then orange goes here. Ah. No, that. Thing is, I need to get up there so that I can then drop down and grab that cube. So, and then the aerial faith plate takes me too far. So what I end up doing is I end up landing over here. But if there's a faith, there's a hard light branch to catch me before I fall, that should do it. So if I put that there, no, there. There we go. So now I do is this, and then. Oh, I'm still getting hit! I'm still getting hit! Yeah, that's the really dangerous thing about turrets, is because when you knock them over, they can still hurt you. Which is really annoying, to be honest. Let me just get that up real quick. Nope, I want it in front. There we go. So, luckily that didn't hurt me too much. I'm honestly not sure if that's how you're supposed to even do it. Okay, so what you can do to get yourself stuck is, I believe, if... I think it's if you get in here with the cube. And then let it shut or something, or... to be honest, I can't really remember, and I'm not even going to bother, to be honest. Ow, stop shooting me!
I'm going through the list of test subjects in cryogenic storage. I managed to find two with your last name. A man and a woman. So that's interesting. It's a small world.
Yeah, we don't actually know what Shell's name is. It's redacted, I believe, in her files. Oh, I'm out of water. Oh well, I can keep going for another half hour.
After this next test, telling you would spoil the surprise. So I'll just give you a hint. It involves meeting two
Wait, is this the test? Let me just... Shush. Oh, yeah, I remember this one. It's a little mean, actually. Sorry. Sorry. Hello. Yeah, I'm getting down there. Let me just... let's see. I have to move that over there. I can't remember how I do that. Well, first of all, I have to go get the other cube. That might help. Yeah, there's a little fun Easter egg hidden in here. I just need to... Gosh, that's such an odd angle. How do I get that over there again? Oh, like this. Sorry, turret. Like I said, I always feel so bad. So you can see these turrets here. This is called the Turret Wife Serenade because they are serenading her Big Mama Turret. Well, most of them are serenading. There's this one over here who's conducting? But it's a really catchy song. I'll let it run for one loop, and then we'll be back on our way. Yeah, turrets got a lot more musical in this game. Alright, and from there it basically loops. I believe there's a bit of a rat den over here. Yes, there is. There's all these coffee cups and bean cans and More lovely art. Such lovely art. What does it say? You and Rality? Rality. I can't read that. And there's some more math up on the walls. And piles of dead bodies of all the scientists who were killed by the neurotoxin. Isn't that delightful? Yeah, down here you can start to get an idea of just how far down this facility goes. And it is mind-blowing how far down you go. I don't know if you actually even reach the bottom. For all I know, it could keep going below that. I don't know how far it goes. But yeah, it's really eerie once you realize just how far up you are. But at the same time, you're still underground, but at the same time, it's it's really crazy. Awesome sense of scale. Really cool sense of mood. Oh, that does go through the glass. I'm sorry. Oh, I guess that's not quite low enough. There we go. I'm sorry, poor turrets. You didn't deserve that. GLaDOS, you monster. Okay, so I think we're going to get to the end of this chapter, and then we're going to stop, because it is 7 o'clock, and I can't seem to stop yawning for some reason.
This test was designed by one of Aperture's Nobel Prize winners. It doesn't say what the prize was for. Well, I know it wasn't for being immune to neurotoxin.
Ha ha! You're so funny, GLaDOS. It's got to be soon, right? The end of the chapter? I feel like it's soon. I don't know, I'm definitely having a lot of deja vu with some of these tests as far as, some of these tests. Sorry, I'm just a little confused. Okay, I remember what I need to do. Okay, so what I want to do is this, so that I've got in a spot where it's still blocking, but it's also over top of the button. So now when I go over to the elevator over here, and I do this. Yep.
I'm getting choked up just thinking about it.
Well, GLaDOS, Lily and I have a surprise of our own coming up. What do you say about that? Yep, chapter for the surprise. I wouldn't say this is it is the end of a chapter, but it's not quite a stopping point. I can't remember how far we have to go to get to one. I think it's pretty close, to be honest, though. I think we can still keep going. We're gonna keep going. Oh, surprise time!
Surprise. In 3, 2,
What is it? Is it a cake?
I made it all up.
Yay, confetti! Confetti's the surprise.
Oh, come on. If it makes you feel any better, they abandoned you at birth. So I very seriously doubt they'd even want to see you.
Yay, confetti. Wait. Why are we up here? Is this... Oh, okay. The pain isn't... Oh! Oh, gosh. Turret over there. Okay. So we were not where I thought I was. But... we can still keep going. Right. Where is... the cube? Cube is over there. Gosh, let's see, if the cube is over there, and I need to get... No, I need to get over there. But how do I get over there without getting hit by the turret? I don't remember! I'm sorry, I'm so bad at this game. Ah, don't want to do that. I don't think this is how it's supposed to be used, but I can use this as a temporary shield. Still can't quite get over there. Wow, I have completely, totally forgotten how to do this test. 100%. Britt. Could I get a hint, please? I'm sure I could figure it out on my own eventually, but I don't want to just be standing here in silence going, what the fuck am I doing? Ah! Shit, I forgot that was my cover. I see a button over there, but I can't get to the button. There's nothing else on the ceiling. I can't shoot through that. Burn the turret with the laser. Okay, I kind of figured that, but I don't have any cubes. I can't redirect that beam over there. I can't get to any of the cubes. I don't think. There's no way to get up there. And the only button I've seen is all the way over there behind a glass wall. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god, I forgot I can do that. Wow. Okay, I really should have seen that. I am really stupid. Okay, cool. Now I can go back over there. I can quick grab this. Don't hit me, 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 don't hit me. Ah! Okay, the other cube is still over there. Alright, gotta make a run for it! That could have gone better. That could have gone much better. Okay. Turret is down. And I'm somehow not dead, although I really should be, to be honest.
I feel awful about that surprise. Tell you what, let's give your parents a call right now.
For those parents who are trying to reach Do Not Mommy, please hang up.
Okay, we've got to be close to getting the stopping point I'm thinking of. Oh, that was a different noise. Where? Wheatley! Okay. Surprise! It's not five more chambers. I don't think so. I hope it's not, because I thought it was a lot sooner than that. I don't know. I don't know. They like to trick you a lot in this game, to be honest.
The old formula. Comedy equals tragedy plus time. And you have been asleep for a while.
Quite a while.
So I guess it's actually pretty funny when you do the math.
Okay, so we're still quite a ways out. Alright, okay, I forgot about a lot of these chambers, to be honest. Okay, and what was that? I think it was this. Oh, there we go. Alright, got that going. Right, so the hard part of this chamber is... I'm already on chamber 19! Huh. Maybe I did do the full 22 chambers. Yeah, the hard part is, getting all of the cubes, because they're all in, interesting spots. But that's what this faith plate is for. Right. Let's see. I gotta. Okay, maybe if I do this. Right. Okay. And then while I'm up here, I throw the orange one. And just there we go. Let's see, and then where do I want to go next? I want to go up there. Oh, wait, the only problem with this is maybe I can do this. Did that work? I honestly can't tell. Did. Ah. Okay, this laser goes there. Lots of lasers on this one. Okay, and then the next cube is up there, so I want to place a portal. Where? I'm going to put it there, I believe, and then I shoot across. Okay, and it's gotta be blue. Ah, just missed it. Oh, wait. It looks like I knocked it off. Oh, I knocked it right into here. Perfect spot. Perfect. So, first thing I want to do is I want to kill these turrets. I'm sorry. Okay, I think that was all of them. And, okay, last thing I want to do then is. One last time on the faith plate, I'm gonna shoot it there. Oh, nope. Oh, wait, no, I did get caught though, so that's good.
I thought about our dilemma, and I came up with a solution that I honestly think works out best for one of both of us.
Neither of us try to kill each other, and you let me go? That would be a great solution.
Federal regulations require me to warn you that this next test chamber is looking pretty good. That's right. The facility is completely operational again.
Yay, look how nice, clean, and shiny it is. Ah, yes, this one. This is a fun one. Total sarcasm on my part. Actually, this is kind of a huge pain, to be honest. As far as I remember. Because everything needs to be. Just so on this one, like that. Ah, This one's going to take me a hot second. Bear with me. Because there's three lasers and two cubes, and of course only one set of portals. I think what I'm supposed to do is I'm supposed to intercept both of them, but then it only still shoots out just one laser. Oh, but the portal shoots out two. Okay. I do remember that now a bit. This one definitely needs the cube, for sure. Which means, yeah, I'm gonna let Britt help me with this one just because it's gonna take forever otherwise. Okay, I do have one going there. Gotta watch where I'm going. Lots of deadly lasers. Right. Okay. And then last but not least, this one. Okay. I actually got that really quick. I just needed the one hint. Usually it takes me forever to get that one. Oh, the companion cubes! Aw.
Just have to look at things objectively, see what you don't need anymore, and trim out the fat.
Fat, I see. Haha, you're calling me fat. So original, GLaDOS, thank you. Honestly, come up with something besides me being adopted or being fat.
Surprise for you after this next test. Not a fake, tragic surprise like last time. A real surprise. With tragic consequences. And real confetti this time. The good stuff. Our last bag. Part of me is going to miss it. But at the end of the day, it was just taking up space.
I see. So, we're in, what test chamber number are we on? That's odd. There's no number? Where's the number? But yeah, I get what she's getting at. We're nearing the end of GLaDOS's tests, the first round of testing. So she's gonna try and kill me again. Yay! This chamber? Well, I'm glad you remember this chamber, Britt, because I don't.
What's going on?
Oh!
Who turned off the lights?
Hey, buddy! I'm speaking in an echo.
It is this chamber!
Beyond her range of hearing.
Look, metal ball, I can hear you.
Run! I don't need to do the voice, run!
Okay, I thought this was later. We're escaping right now. Okay. I didn't realize it was this chamber.
Quick word about the future plans that I've got in store. We're gonna shut down your turret production line, or I turn off your neurotoxin and then you put them for the moment. Run!
Gotta run. I don't even know where Wheatley is. I think I'm ahead of him. Yeah, I was. Ah, I'm stuck. I'm gonna save this real quick because there's a funny achievement if you do this.
So my new friend came up with.
A what?
Look!
Where are you going? Where are you going?
Oh, look. There's a deer. You probably can't see it. Get closer.
Oh. Whoops. Oh no, I'm dead. I believe the achievement, I already got it, which is why I didn't flash up, is good listener. Look, it's even a companion cube. Oh wait, no, it's not. That's just the lighting. I can't see. Where am I going? There's a lot of changing direction in this one. And the high speed, high risk chase is promptly cut short by a loading screen. And we're back. Stop shooting me!
You're okay? Great, come on! This way, this way!
I say this a lot, but this is really good music. Ah! Nope, just gotta keep running. No! Oh. Nope. Didn't quite get it. Okay, let's be a bit smarter about this time and do that. Now I can't get shot. Yay! Oh my, that was close. And just as we hit the 2 hour mark, I believe this is our stopping point. Yep, there's a loading screen, so right after we get through here, and I believe Wheatley's gonna talk for a bit, I'm gonna let him talk, and then we will end the stream. Yep, Chapter 5, The Escape. This is the stopping point I was looking for. Actually, this is perfect. Wheatley doesn't even have to talk. Alright, cool. So we're going to stop right here. Let me get that up. Alright, awesome. Thank you for watching, everybody. Thanks for coming. We made some good progress. We got through 4 whole chapters this time. So I believe our next stream is going to be Monday night? Yeah, because today's Saturday, right? Ryan is streaming Sunday, and then I'd be streaming Monday. Okay. Alright, so yeah, I'll try and get these episodes on YouTube as quickly as possible. Thanks for coming, everybody! Have a very portal Christmas, a very portal December, and I'll see you next time, and we'll start with the fun stuff with Wheatley. It's gonna be great. Okay, thanks for coming. Bye.